person to us. Big names, we were there. Big names, big people. Big building, y'all don't hear me. And the rap, one of the singers got up, remember this? Remember this, Elder Saucer? We was in Columbus and he said this. The Lord told us we should always praise. That's not in the Bible, but the Bible said men should always pray and not faint. The reason why we are unconscious in the spirit and we done fainted, we done stopped praying. The reason why we don't have no victory, we done stopped praying. We come to church, nobody prayed no more. How many of us go to church? They don't shut in. There used to be a time when folks stayed in the church for the weekend until Shiloh came. Nobody knows about that. What? You stay in the church, you don't go to your house and lay in your bed. You mean you tell me you in the church praying? Yes, I'm here because I'm trying to get myself anchored in God. I'm barely hanging on. I'm barely having strength. I barely got the victory. I barely can sleep at night. My life is upside down and topsy-turvy. I'm going through this and I'm going through that. I can't take it. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. That's why the Lord told Israel, you ain't got to keep going through what you're going through. I got about 8 more minutes. Hallelujah on my clock. Hello here. You got to understand that the Lord was letting them know that I am the King of Israel. When you read more in verse in chapter 43 and 44, the Lord said, there is no other around me, none that I know of. He said, I am the only God. There is no God like unto me. He told them in Leviticus, the 19th chapter, be thou holy, for the Lord thy God is holy. Y'all don't hear me in here. What happened to holiness? The Bible said, follow peace with all men, and holiness without. Somebody said, I don't want holiness. That's that church down the street. I'm Baptist. If you Baptist, you better be holy. If you Methodist, you better get another method to get holy. If you Catholic, you better become more universal and be holy. If you Lutheran, you better be holy. Hello, Martin Luther. You better learn how. And holiness ain't a word. And holiness not a description. And holiness not taking off your weave. Holiness ain't pulling down your dress. Holiness ain't taking off your lipstick. Holiness is stop lying when you take off your lipstick. Holiness is quit raising hell. Holiness is quit giving people the finger on the freeway when they cut you off. Holiness is praying when you're going through something. Oh, help me in here. Can I ask y'all a question? Can I preach? Too late. I'm already preached. You gotta understand that holiness is not a game. If we gonna make it to heaven, we gonna have to be holy. Amen. I don't care what you say you are, but you gonna have to have holiness tied to you. Holiness is a requirement. Holiness is how you live. For the Lord said, come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord. Why are you saying all this to us? Sound like you're rapping. No, no, not at all. You gotta understand, before you get the things that God has for you, there are certain circumstances and certain ways to live before God give it. He said, if my people, I am pertaining to you, it's up to you, according to you. It ain't that God don't give it. Folks walking around off of a prophecy. I seen a little cute fella on the television, had his eyebrows arched, had a curl, and he was on the telephone. How they gonna get this if you join up with me? Just as cute as he can be, just as effeminate as they come, just as sweet as sugar. Y'all don't hear me in here. And I sat there and I looked. I said, can't folks see this? The Bible said, we know you by the fruit that you bear. We ain't all perfect. But some stuff is just crazy. We ain't all, amen, 100%. But some stuff, you gonna follow behind. Y'all don't hear me in here. I looked at this and I shook my head. I said, anybody that get behind this, you got to be crazy. Let me tell you something. The difference between him and a psychic person is nothing. They're doing the same thing. They both get money and they both telling you stuff. And they, amen, it's called familiar spirits. They can tap in and see you lonely. They can tap in and see you struggling. They can tap in and see this and say that. And you got to understand, here is a prophecy for you. A lot of us run from church to church, pillar to post, looking for a prophecy. But I'm going to give you a prophecy. Take this with you. The gift of God is eternal life. And the wages of sin, they are death. You must realize and recognize that God is, amen, set you up so you can be blessed, but not set you up so you can be destroyed. I got 5 minutes and I'm closing out. Let me repeat this one more time to you. Remember you're not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I'll do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Notice this, I'll make a way in the wilderness and a river in the desert. Anybody in here ever been in the wilderness? Anybody in here ever been in a desolate place? You needed God to bring you out. You needed God to deliver you. But while you were going through what you were going through, Satan tried to get you to remember where you come from. Satan tried to tell you, remember, when you was in the world, you had this, that, and the other. You always had money in the bank, and you wasn't struggling. Remember, you had this boyfriend for this, and this girlfriend for that. Remember, you had things working for you. But this man, that's what she trying to do to you. But the Bible said, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you can ask for me. I know some of you probably thought I was going to come out here and talk to you. This ain't no television 700 club testimony. I come here to tell you tonight, you better forget that. Forget the lies that came. Forget the issues that you've been through. Bishop, I remember the scars and the pain. And I remember how some people have lied on me and mistreated me. Forget that, baby. You can't dwell on that kind of thing. When you dwell on that nonsense, it kills you. I look at some of us in the body of Christ. We come to church and we're dry. We don't have no joy. We come to church and sit up like we're in a baby seat, a car seat. We sit up like we're a tombstone. We just is dead and dry. The Lord Jesus Christ didn't shed all that blood for you to sit here like you don't even know it. When you read Father, he said, these people have I formed for myself. They shall show forth my praise. What you saying, priest? Amen. I don't care what you've been through. Take the mindset of deep. I'm going to look at y'all, but over there, they look mean. I'm going to bless the Lord at all times. I'm just trying to find somebody that in here that forgot that and ready to receive this. Hallelujah. When you stuck on the old stuff don't allow you to be free. The old stuff don't allow you to have peace. The old stuff don't allow you to sleep. You still mad at Johnny because Johnny let you down. You still mad at Sapphira because the Sapphira lied on you. You still mad at Cleophas because Cleophas stole something from you. You better cheer up. The Bible says in this life you should have tribulation, but be of a good cheer because I overcome the world. I told you the other night, according to the Bible, many are the afflictions of the righteous. Shove your neighbor in the shoulder. Say, don't you expect this? Don't you recognize it? You're supposed to go through something. Quit acting like you ain't been through nothing. I love folks that been through something. Don't bring me somebody over here that's going to talk cool, calm, and collected and tell me hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got some folk in church talking about silence is golden and still waters run deep, but dead water don't move at all. If you ever go over into the Middle East, they got something called the Dead Sea. Nothing goes out and nothing comes in. And some of you are like the Dead Sea. I refuse to die after all that God has allowed me to get through. Because the more I dwell on it, it affects my joy. The more I hang on it, it affects my joy. Somebody lied on you, forget that. Somebody mistreated you, forget